In today's video, I'm gonna explain and show you how we can complete the Selene quest. This is the side quest, very, very important, and especially if you are a wizard, you must do this. Because you're gonna get a lot of nice items for wizards, but also, you know what, overall nice items. First things first, we have to reach Selene and we have to start the quest, obviously. The location it will be right here are the Waypoint Ruins. Probably most of you already know how to be here because this is the place for you to buy spells, the first place in the game where you can buy spells. And as you probably all know, you have to defeat this pumpkin head. I'm gonna guide you step by step. I'm gonna give you all the options that we have in this quest, and I'm gonna show in this video a lot of rewards. So after you're gonna defeat this guy, you will have to pass that green wall and talk for the first time with Selene, that it's a sorcerer or a wizardess, I don't know the term. Yeah, probably it's a sorceress or something like that. That gonna have a pretty interesting quest. Yeah, not a long one, it's a medium. And compared to other quests, it's the length of this quest, it will be medium. You have to unlock certain regions in this game, like the Mount Gelmir, like the Volcano Manor, but definitely it will be worth it. Now, this will be your first discussion with her. After you're gonna discuss with her the next location where you want to be, it will be at the on a site at the Volcano Manor, just on a not a river, I don't know how to call that region, but I'm gonna show you. And if you have any trouble to reach Volcano Manor, this is just a quick guideline of how you can be there. From the Grand Lift of Dectus, you have to use that medallion, and then you can just travel to this location and then to the Forest Spinning Great Bridge. You'll be teleported right over here. You'll find the Mount Gelmir and you can just reach the Volcano Manor. And then from that location, it will be pretty simple to reach the Seatwater Terminus. Again, if you don't know how to be here, I already have a video on my channel how you can reach this location and how you can reach the Hermit Village. Because yes, we're gonna pass to our village, but that it's in I don't know, if you want to explore that village, I have a video with that. Now, let's keep going. On the left side, from time to time, I'm going to show you the map so you don't get lost. Basically, what we are doing here is to go to take a spell, the most important spell in this game. Definitely the most important one. But also, if you are here, you can defeat a magma worm. For me, it's already defeated, but you can fight with that little dragon. And you're going to get a dragon heart if you defeat that. If not, you just want to run. Just run to this location until we're gonna reach the primal sorcerer Azur, I think it's called. Now, everything is just a little bit on fast forward. I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want to skip parts. I want to show how you can reach that that location. So let's just go. We have to reach the Hermit Village first, and then behind the stone, a rock, we will find that sorcerer, but also we will find a grace site, a site of grace, which it will be very important to take. This will be the Hermit Village. Let's keep going. Behind this rock, here you can find the demigod. It will be a Ritter boss that you can fight, but you can skip that fight only by resting here. At the Primeval, I don't know how to pronounce that word, let's see, Primeval Sorcerer Azur, and your sorcerer will be right over here. Just talk with him, it will not say any word, only some suspension points. So no words from this guy, but you're gonna get the Comet Azur spell, which again, it's very, very important at this moment. Now, next step, go back to the You know, I'm crazy like that. I always forgot the names. Waypoint Ruins, Sorceress Selene. Yeah, Selene is the name. Go back to Selene, talk with her, tell her about the spell that you just got, the Comet Azur spell. Show Azur sorcery. Yep. And you're gonna get a long dialogue, just complete every single dialogue that this NPC will have, that the Selene will have. Take your time and just listen to her. I just cut at parts because I don't want to ruin all your story. So yeah, You can just talk with her about a lot of things, and she will tell you about another sorcerer that we have to find, and that will be my the next location where we have to go. Just keep talking with her. The Master Lusat, it will be the name of that sorcerer, but just talk with her until you will get this key, the Celian Sealbreaker. This is very important. Without this key, don't go in the cave that I'm about to show you, to the secret cave, to the Celian, what is the name of that cave? Celian Hideaway, something like that. So from the first step, you have to make your way to a location, to a Church of the Plague. You can go by you can go there by going to the third Church of Marika. You will be teleported from that river here, and from that location just go down until you will see the Church of the Plague. If you don't know how to reach the Church of Plague, again I remember that I have a video on my channel. This again is just a quick guideline of how you can be there. I just showed you on the map, but if you have trouble finding this location, I have a video dedicated to this church. Church of the Plague, it will be the name of this church. And from that church, you want to go, let me show you the direction, behind the church on this hill. Just climb the hill and you'll see a sorcerer, wizard, I don't know what is that, this NPC. I'm not very sure if you have to defeat this guy, but I defeated anyway, so... yeah, and behind this monument you will see a secret cave. Fight a little bit with that wall, just give it a swing of a sword and it will disappear, and you'll discover the new secret Celia Hideaway. Now from this location, all you have to do is to follow me step by step, because we have to reach the that sorcerer that we are searching for, the Lusat sorcerer. Now follow me. And if you reach this bottom of the cave, here you're gonna have to use the key right over here. It's gonna be this spelled wall, I don't know how to call it, the sealed door, and use the key right here. I just showed you the key, that's you don't have to enter into the menu, and you can talk with this, it's not dead yet but almost, you can talk with this NPC. You're gonna get the Stars of Ruin, and now you will be able to see that you cannot teleport outside because you didn't defeat the main boss from this area. If you defeat the main boss from this area, you can teleport wherever you like, but I'm gonna show you the exit. Just follow my steps. I want to get you out of this cave. Okay, don't fight this boss like I just tried to do. Just go to those lights. These three lights are the way. Just climb the stairs, and I just want to get you out safe from this cave without losing your runes. But you can always let yourself dead and you'll lose your runes, but we are not we don't want to do that. Now let's reach the outside of this cave, the exit of the cave, the first basically the gray side, and then we can exit outside. I don't know why they made it that way, that you cannot teleport. You will lose 1 or 2 minutes doing this. From this location, now it's safe to teleport. The next thing is to defeat Radahn. If you already defeated Radahn, you can skip this step, but if not, let me show how you can reach Radahn. Radahn, it's a main boss in this game that I have a video of how you can defeat that boss, how you can find him, how you can chase him. I have videos with Radahn, a lot of them, but basically you want to be right over here to the Impossible Great Bridge. From this location, we want to teleport Again, this part, few seconds. It will be just for me to explain how we can find Radahn. Then at the red main castle, if you are here, you will have to take the Site of Grace, that it's right here on the right side. You can talk with all the NPCs that are there, because there are some other side quests that you have to talk. And then just find this on the balcony, this Jared. It's very important, talk with him. And your battle with Radahn will begin, after you're gonna talk with this NPC. After the battle, it will be over and you defeated Radahn. We have to go back to the Selina. This will be the end part of Radahn defeating. I just defeated this boss. If you have trouble defeating this guy, I have a video on my channel how you can defeat him very easy. So, better watch that. And the next way where we're gonna be, it will be right here to the waypoint cellar where Selen will be. Selen, yes. Now we're gonna have another dialogue with her after you defeated Radahn. And we have to find at the Church of Marika, the second one, I think, or we're gonna see. We got to find another shape, another form of this sorcerer. We have to take a certain item from that location. I know it can be a little bit complicated, but if you just follow every step that I just showed you, you'll be you don't have any trouble. Now, okay, the fourth Church of Marika. It will be right here. So, from the first step, I'm going to show you the basics, but again, on my channel, I have a video of how you can find the fourth Church of Marika. Just follow my path that I'm showing right now. This will be the location where you want to be. Fourth Church of Marika. I have to repeat, I have a dedicated video with this church. Sorry for repeating, but I just want to let you know, because you may have trouble finding this church. Now, just go, I'm going to show you on the map also, just go to these ruins, to the Witchbane ruins, and just go downstairs in this basement. Be careful of those NPC, they will follow you, and they might be ruin your quest, but you can go back to the Church of Vows and redeem yourself if you attack Selen. Talk with her, and you'll have this option to retrieve the, what is the primal, let's see what is the name, the primal glintstone, Selen primal glintstone. After you're gonna get that item, you can reload the game and you can just talk with Jared. This is just a more context. You can reload the game, talk with him, and your next location, it will be here at the Rani's Rise. Probably you already know how to be at the Rani's Rise. If you don't know, again, yes, I have a video on my channel with that. But basically, you have to be at the Rani's Rise. And from this location, we're gonna start. Just go outside. On the left, you will see a secret underground area that I already discovered, but for you, it will be hidden. So all you have to do here is to roll, and you'll discover this basement. Just roll. I discovered when I did the Selvius questline. Now, here you're gonna have this message, and in this message, you're gonna have a hidden door right here. You just have to hit it, and you'll discover the other shape of Selen. Just interact with her. And now we are going to another location, which is again very important. Let me tell you, you have to defeat also Renala, the Queen Renala from the Royal Lucaria Academy, the main boss. Obviously, I have a video on my channel how you can defeat her. And you have to unlock, I told you this, this requires a lot, but not the most complicated quest. Royal Lucaria Grand Library, just go to that Site of Grace after you defeated Renala. So definitely you have to defeat Renala to proceed. Now, you will have two options. Here is gonna be the crazy part. You can defeat Selen and side with Jared, or you can side with Selen and defeat Jared, I think is the name, or Jaren, let's see. Yeah, probably. Let me explain both of the options. One option, if you try to side with Jaren, you'll get an ancient smithing stone, and that's it, and a mask. I will not recommend you to do that. But if you decide to side with Selen and to accept to help Selen, which I just did, I'm gonna show how many items you're gonna get. Basically, With the one, you're gonna defeat Selen, and I will not recommend you to do that. And with the second, you're gonna defeat Jaren. So I sided with Selen. For me, this is the best outcome that you can choose. If you are in the new game plus and you already did, you can choose the otherwise, obviously. So after I just defeated Jared, you're gonna get this awesome armor suit, armor from Jared, which is looks absolutely amazing. And then you can talk with her. If you talk with her two times, you're gonna get a knife, which is very, very awesome. I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. This will be your first dialogue, and then we're gonna get more and more items that are amazing. You're gonna get a big dialogue, and yeah, another tragic outcome, because the Selen, it will be the last time when you're gonna see it like this in a human shape. I'm gonna explain. So this will be my second dialogue. You're gonna get the Glintstone Kris, which is a really, really rare item that you can get only by completing this quest. And all you have to do is to reload the game. Okay, you're gonna get another dialogue. And now you can get a new spell from Selen, the Shard Spiral. Yep, I think this is new. I never had that one. And the next thing you have to do is to reload the game right here. Just rest Other Grace. And you will be noticed that Renala, it will be here on her chair again. You're gonna get this new item, the Witch Glintstone Crown. But you also will see this is Selen, the new form. Yeah, I know. Now, just go to the two wizards that we just been to. Here is gonna be the Azure Wizard. I think Azure is the name. And get the armor set. Very important. And the second location is to be at Lusat Glintstone in the cave. And that's it. This is the all the quest. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Like, subscribe, share, press the notification bell if you want to see more videos from my channel. And yes, I'm gonna do all the side quests for you. You just got yourself 3 armor set and a lot of items. So yeah, enjoy. Bye.